Hello there, folks, and welcome back to another adventure in our playthrough in the visual novel, If My Heart Had Wings, Flight Diary. Currently on the chapters of Hotaru Himegi and her experience in the Soaring Club, and apparently also her nursing adventures for our dear protagonist, Aoi Minase. Yeah, she has literally become basically his nurse in a way. I mean, what else way to describe it? Babysitter? I mean, seriously, but no, she's just doing her due diligence, but ultimately, Aoi is trying to get across to her too that his injury is not her fault, but she still wants to be of use in his recovery, which is understandable, and that's also very, very, very nice of her, because she's known to not really take any particular initiative. So being that she is taking this kind of initiative now, it could help in her development as well in that regard. So in the last episode, she was giving Aoi a massage to try to relax the muscles and everything in his leg, because apparently he's got a little leg injury right now. He did go and see the school nurse, and the school nurse did help him out with some things as that. But of course, Hotaru is also helping him out in that regard, along with his regular chores and whatnot at the dormitory. So apparently in the last episode before we cut it off, there was something that became more awkward as she was administering the massage. So let's find out what that is. Here we go. Hotaru leaned in for a closer grip on me. Now she was wrapped around my leg. If I moved even a little, I was going to bump her right against her chest. Oh, come on. Just ignore it, dude. Just ignore it. Stay still and just ignore it. Being this close to a girl was, well, yeah. Passions of youth, blah, blah, blah. That shiny hair, the graceful line from her cheek to her throat, those delicate shoulders. Aoi, focus! Focus! I don't think I've ever taken such a long, hard look at Hotaru since coming back to this town. I just considered her the same little girl who always used to trail along behind me and her sister. When I was reunited with Aga, she seemed really proud of how she'd matured. Physically, anyway. And Hotaru, she wasn't a child anymore. She'd grown into a fine young woman. A sudden jolt of pain cut through my sentimental train of thought. No. I was, it wasn't really. In this case, it hadn't been the old injury, just my leg seizing up a little from being in the same position for so long. Hotaru looked downhearted for a moment, but continued the massage, taking care to move to a different spot. Now I was feeling a different kind of pain. I knew my body well, and I knew this wasn't good. Putting too much weight on that spot might actually do some serious damage. That right there, that's where the problem is. She touched it more gently this time, tentatively, seeking out just the right spot. It sent a weird shiver running up my spine. Yeah, right there. I think that's where the pain centered. Otaru's hands tenderly caressed my skin. She went slowly and carefully, doing her best not to set off any painful spots, her palms and fingers exploring all over. You can put a little more force into it there if you want. You could no longer call this a massage. It felt less focused, more intimate. I began to tremble all over, struggling not to think impure thoughts about sweet, innocent Hotaru. Okay, folks, hashtag protect Hotaru, so if he acts up, we jump in the screen and we attack. Hashtag protect Hotaru. I'm sure these desires were perfectly natural for a healthy, red-blooded young man like myself. But this wasn't the time or place. That's what I'm talking about, Aoi. And see? That's what it comes down to, folks. If you ever hear that notion, if you ever hear that common statement that it's human nature, even though it is, that doesn't mean that it should just be allowed to run without any type of moderation whatsoever. Because that lack of moderation has led to a lot of complications and liabilities. So human nature is no excuse to allow oneself to run loose. Lesson of the day, or at least one of them so far. Not the way I would have phrased it. Yeah. No. I had to remember this was Hotaru. It wasn't her fault I was reading too much into her words and actions. I took a deep breath to steady my nerves and push back those dirty thoughts. Good job, Aoi. I think maybe it's better like this. I place my hand over Hotaru's. About this heart is fine. I put in just the right amount of pressure. Hotaru gave out a little squeak with each squeeze. I'd like it if you could keep that up. Is that okay? It won't tire you out or anything, will it? I took my hand away. Hotaru looked like she was spacing out. She was putting more power into her massage now. Ah, that feels good. Keep going. She continued kneading the flesh of my leg. I knew Hotaru wasn't as strong as me. She had to put a lot of effort into it, and her breathing was getting a little ragged. Now that I thought about it, seeing Hotaru so out of breath was a pretty unusual sight. Since coming back, I'd never seen her physically exert herself very much. She never ran around with the rest of us or ran to avoid being late or stuff like that. I felt like I was witnessing something that was a secret from the rest of the world. I'd been struggling for a while now to keep my mind out of the gutter. Keep at it. You got this, buddy. You got this. For her part, Hotaru was starting to flush, and her body was getting closer and closer to mine. This was getting way too sketchy. I instinctively shot out my hand toward my phone. Okay, sit on in the chair and take five, Hotaru. Yeah, just right over there. Right over there. Just sit over there and, you know, just take five. Hotaru took a break and tried to catch her breath. That was a close one. Hey, Agaha. I hope I didn't sound too flustered. Dinner? Sure. No problem. Hotaru can help me out. What? What did I say? Hey, wait a minute. What are you suggesting? Of course. Don't say that. You're her sister. These folk, man. Why you? That's the angriest or most stern or assertive I have ever seen Otaru. And I gotta tell you, that actually sends a chill down my spine. Great. Now Otaru was trying to stand up. Whoa! Her face was so close. She might have snatched the phone away completely if I hadn't put it on loudspeaker.
います。葵と何してた？マッサージしてあげてました。ああ、山崎のおっちゃんに習ってたの、それか。やりすぎちゃダメだよ。素人なんだからね。はい。悪化させたら本末転倒。そんな子は家に連れ戻すから。はい。
That's going a little far.
Aoi, そこはきちんとしなきゃダメだよ。あんたに迷惑かけるために泊まり込み許してるわけじゃないんだから。
Okay, but ease up a little. She means well, and she's doing her best here.
足悪化させないことが一番大事なのよ。今うちの部で人乗せて飛べるのは葵だけなんだから。
Alright, so why don't... Hey! Why don't y'all just get Asa up? She wants to get her pilot's license too. Get her trained up. Huh? Huh? Just a thought. I know. Trust me. I'm more concerned about this than anyone. But I trust Hotaru. I know she wouldn't do anything to hurt me.
Aoi.
Hai, hai. Hotaru, 今の聞いたね。 信じてもらえるように。
しっかりしなさいよ。はい。じゃあやっぱ今晩そっち行くのやめるわ。は？ホタルいないなら私が家に戻らないと。お父さん泣いちゃうし。そうだね。濡れた枕をお母さんが干すことに。
Mr. Himegi, is this really how you act just because your daughters ain't in the house and they're growing up and developing a life of their own? I'm pretty sure he's gonna say, get some kids and you'll see what it's like. Like, dude, no. Just how emotionally delicate was their dad? Yeah, seriously. Aga hung up and the two of us were left in silence. Stare. Otaru was staring at me intently. I think that's enough massages for one day. Thanks. Anyhow. I've got dinner to cook, so I'd like to get out.
わかった.
Otaru meekly withdrew.
Oni?
Hmm?
今の嬉しかった。
The stuff about me trusting you?
Huh.
That's true, you know? I patted Hotaru on the head. Oh, stop it. You know you love the head pats. I mean, come on now. Head pats are awesome. If I do say so myself. Your face went beet red. Okay, I'm gonna get dressed. She slinked off somewhat reluctantly. Hey, maybe you can give me a massage again some other time.
Hey.
Her face lit up into a bright smile. Otaru was cute and so easy to read, too. Now was the time I'd usually deal with any chores I didn't have time for in the morning. Today, Otaru took charge of the cleaning while I sorted through the dorm's mail. I preferred being on the move. I wasn't used to sitting still like this for so long. Thanks. Otaru shouldered the vacuum and walked up the stairs. I watched her go until she was out of sight. Those slender legs of hers were real pretty. Outwardly, she was completely different from the little Otaru I'd known before. I really had to stop thinking of her as a little kid. I managed to convince Hotaru to let me help make dinner. I couldn't let you do it all on your own. Besides, I'm used to this work. Hey, this is probably the first time we've cooked together, isn't it? Hey, watch your hand. No looking away while holding a knife. That's an iron-clawed law in the kitchen. Yeah! I must have made a bad misstep, because right then the old pain flared up again.
Oni?
Yeah. I put all my effort into masking the pain. Was she buying it? Of course she ain't buying it. She knows you better than that. What's wrong? You stopped. You can't let yourself get distracted when you have a knife in your hand.
Hi.
Let's hurry up. Everyone will be home soon. The conversation died after that. We prepared the rest of the meal nearly in complete silence. Hotaru kept a close eye on me the whole time. Oh, bless her sweet little heart.
ただいま!
ただいまです!
戻りました。
Everyone arrived all at once. Welcome home, everybody.
おかえりなさい。
No one was especially surprised to see Hotaru. Agaha had told them all about the situation already. Despite that... Now this was an uncomfortable silence. Without Aga here to take the lead, no one really knew how to approach her. Hotaru herself was so shy, she spent most of her time hiding behind me. Well, this was awkward. Okay, good to see you all. Dinner will be ready in no time at all. Hotaru let out a sigh of relief. I patted her head. You don't have anything to apologize for.
Yeah,
just give it some practice and development, it'll happen. Agaha is Agaha. Nothing wrong with being yourself. No one's expecting you to be exactly like her. Just relax and go with it. My guess was she felt like an outsider, not being one of the original dorm residents. That's who we're missing. Welcome back.
Oh, Hotaru-chan. Aikawarazu kawaii ne. Ne, Aoi-kun. Hotaru-chan, karitete ii?
What are you planning to do? Huh?
Heya no osouji tetsudatte morau to motte. Iroiro tatande hoshii mono toka aru shi.
No, you fold up your own clothes. You need practice. Do it yourself.
Hai, irasshai.
Kidnapping in progress. I moved to intercept her, but Kaneko stopped me with a look.
Hai. Kawaii, kawaii, Hotaru-chan. Onee-san ga kawaii gatte agiru kara ne. Kou miete mo onee-san, kawaii ko ga daisuki nano sa. Meippai kawaii gatchaimasu yo.
Hotaru reached out a hand toward me, begging for help. It was all in vain. Kaneko dragged her away and disappeared into their dorm. It was all in vain. Kaneko dragged her away and disappeared into her room. Jeez, Kaneko, really?
というわけで... ホタルちゃんの協力を仰いだのですが、目的のものが見つかりませんでした。すごかった。
Kaneko, what did you do? If you did something retarded, I'm gonna jump through this screen. And ain't nobody gonna stop me except maybe just reality and the laws of physics. Which I'm sure we can figure out a way to get past that. I'm sure we can get past that somehow. Somehow! What have you been showing her in there? And I think we should probably take a break and find out on the next episode what she might have shown her. And hopefully it was something that was of the utmost of purity and innocence. Cause our dear Hotaru don't corrupt you, Hotaru. Anyways, all right. Well, with that, I want to thank everyone for watching this video this time around. If you like what you saw, maybe consider leaving a like. And if you'd like to see more, and I haven't probably scared you away with my weird sense of undignified humor, then maybe consider subscribing. And until next time, happy mixing, everyone.